You see my name. Well, why is there a line right here? Yeah. Give it a second, cause it might not turn on right away. Cause there's like a 10-second delay. Yeah, you just gotta wait a couple seconds. Wait a minute, and then it should be on there. Yeah, just wait a little bit. Wait a little bit. No worries. No worries.
Was that the first time?
I can see you back. Can you see it?
Sorry.
First time you killed somebody. It always does something to you the first time. Then you get used
to it. Shot that guy, right?
I don't want to talk about it, okay? That's him.
Miroslav Korda?
Yeah?
Lieutenant Carter Blake, I'd like to ask you some questions.
Ooh.
Shit, don't just stand here. He's gonna get away.
Ah! Hey, man, watch it.
Ah. Hey, what's the matter with you?
I ran out. Dude, what's going on? Messing up a lot.
Hey man, watch it.
Oh, got him. Okay, the beat should pop on me.
Hey man, what's your problem?
Oh. Chickens. Get out of here, chickens. Time to kill one more person.
Where the fuck is Blake? Shit! Where'd he go? I can't see anything here.
Hey, Crystal Tech Gaming.
No way he's escaping. I'm gonna get that bastard. Damn place is freezing. My hands are numb.
You wait a minute. There we go. Where is he? Oh! Oh, I got him. Ooh, dude. Ah, I keep messing up. Boom. 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 Oh. Aw, dude. What are you gonna do? You can help me or not? It's about time. All because I missed that one quick time event. I know, I got hit a bunch. Inches.
Mm. Oh. Hmm.
A little drink. Try to at least open a solve a murder or a disappearance. No, but the little boy's lights.
I've seen the parents of all the victims, and all I've come up with is this telephone and a box of origami figures. All the newspapers are talking about Sean Mars, the kid who disappeared. I can't breathe in this goddamn humidity. Hope it stops raining soon. I needed the rest. I haven't been sleeping well since the murder started up again.
That's right. I have yet, Charles. And lay down for a while. Take a load off. Looks uncomfortable. Get the door. Am I getting into a fight? Is that the door right there?
You said I could contact you if I remembered anything. Can I come in?
Sure. Please, take a seat.
I just remembered something. Maybe it's not important, but a letter arrived in the mail the morning Johnny disappeared.
A letter? What kind of a letter?
It was addressed to Johnny's father. I don't know what was inside it, but he read it and then he left. That's the last time I saw him.
And you think there's a connection between that letter and Johnny's death, is that it? You remember anything else about the letter?
Well, I don't know why, but I kept the envelope.
Nothing particular. Except the address.
The address?
It was typed with an old typewriter. Could be a lead, you never know. Well, thanks for your help, Lauren. I'll let you know if it leads to anything.
Wait, I can't just sit around and do nothing while you're out there looking for the man who killed my son. Ever since you came around, I've been thinking, and I want to come with you. Help you in your investigation?
There's nothing you can do to help, Lauren. It's not a good idea. Believe me.
If you won't let me help you, I'm keeping the envelope. It's all or nothing.
Listen, an investigation like this is dangerous. And I don't have time to play the bodyguard.
How many clues have you got, Mr. Shelby? This envelope may be your only link to the killer. I understand. It was a stupid idea. Sorry for wasting your time, Mr. Shelby.
Wait. You're really something special, Lauren.
Ooh.
I'll give you that.
I'm just a mother. A mother who wants to find out who killed her son. Are we partners?
We're partners.
We're partners.
House is this?
Maybe you better stay in the car.
We're partners, remember? Wherever you go, I go.
Come to see Gordy Kramer.
Kramer? The big wig tycoon from Kramer Construction?
No, his son.
You think maybe he's the origami killer?
But now I just have a few questions that need answers. Kramer, you stay here till I come back, okay?
Okay. Just let me know if you need me.
Have you seen Gordy?
Sorry, no.
Whiskey straight up, no ice.
Relax.
Hey, man. You think you could help me out?
Do I look like a dealer? Get out of here!
Let me look there. See that guy? I can't. Very important. Oh, hello.
Hi. Great party, huh? Hi. I haven't seen you before. Well, let's get better acquainted, pal.
Does have a quirk. Now I got me a new friend.
You gonna give me a stick?
Hi, I'm Scott. I'm looking for Gordy. Have you seen him?
Is it a fight? Oh, is it up there?
Hi, I'd like to see Gordy.
Gordy hasn't seen anyone. Beat it.
Look, you just tell him that Scott Shelby wants to speak to him. Okay?
You're starting to piss me off, man. Now beat it before I get angry.
I want to see Gordy Kramer. I'm going to have to go about it some other way.
I think he go here, didn't he? That guy? I'm trying.
So, did you find Gordy?
He's upstairs. He's got two goons blocking the way.
Leave it to me. Just be ready to go as soon as they leave the stairs.
Wait, Lord.
Here you go, here you go, here you go. Here you go, here you go. Good job, Lauren, good job. You take those big doors.
Sorry.
You learn?
That
Where'd Lauren go? She still knocked out in the ground. Just looking around. You're right. No, no one's watching. No. Noah was, and some other person was, but the other person left. It's like a more boring game to watch than a multiplayer game or something. How'd I get in there? There's Lauren right there, look. You know? He's here. Sitting on the couch. How do I get in there? Oh, I know. I know. Here. No, it won't let me. Oh, let me get in that way then. I gotta climb the... Okay. Don't give me the option anymore. Isn't that where I came from?
Mr. Kramer?
Shh! This is the best part!
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. I'm investigating the case of the Origami Killer. I'd like to ask you a few questions. I'd like to know exactly what happened to little Joseph Brown.
Beat it! You hear me? Get the hell out of here!
Uh-oh, things get good.
What do you want?
A witness saw little Joseph Brown get in the back of your limousine. That was the last time anybody ever saw him. Now, I know you've been arrested and interrogated until your father made a little phone call and the file was closed. I'd like to hear your version of the facts.
The kid was lost. I just offered to drive him home. The police arrived, I explained the misunderstanding, and I was released. End of story. Nothing to get excited about, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're a good Samaritan taking kids home who happen to get lost right next to your limousine? Now be a nice guy and tell me something I can believe.
Very well. I'm the Origami Killer. I get my victims into my car. I drown them in rainwater. Then I dump them on a wasteland with an origami figure in one hand and an orchid on their chest. I do that because I'm bored, Mr. Shelby. And it's a creative and entertaining way of having fun. Is that good enough for you? Or do you want more? This interview is over.
Get rid of this clown!
Oh. 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 In the butt. But he's next.
It's a dangerous game you're playing, Kramer.
Do you know who my father is? He only has to lift one finger and you won't wake up tomorrow morning. You're the one that should be afraid, Mr. Shelby. Not me.
Crazy. Ooh, a tough guy trophy. One more day of work, babe. It's been a long week. Oh, it's right, babe. And you're off, too. Cool. I think you're off. I'll record it. Not that way. Where am I again? I forgot. Is it the penitentiary or something? Looks like a prison. Arc map? Whoa. Oh yeah, you're right. Arc map.
This is the old Pico power station. I thought it was abandoned. It might be a trap. Electrical condensers. Going by the sound of them, they're still active.
And there. Ooh, a furnace. It looks like a furnace. Here we go. Oh. They're gonna turn it on.
I should never have got into this pipe. It's suicide.
Where's this pipe go?
Whoa! Glass. Broken glass. Sharp as a razor. Impossible to go back. I'm gonna have to crawl through it, slowly, so I don't tear up my arms. Match flame. It indicates where the fresh air comes from. All I have to do is follow the wind.
Hold on.
What's that noise? Rats. Charming. If they got in, then maybe I can get out.
Oh, come around. Well, I can't go forward. I tried it, it won't let me go. I tried. See?
Can't stand the pain. Can't take it much longer. Can't see a thing in here. Where are those matches? I've got to get out of here. There's got to be a way out.
Now what? Won't let me go forward. I keep putting all these matches. Not.
Stupid fucking pipe!
And Sean is gonna die because of me. Keep it together, Ethan. Come on.
Going backwards. There you go. I got here. I think you're around. There you go. Slow. Okay, let me turn on the fight. Yeah. Match. If you follow the flame. Yeah, that way.
I will not give up. I'm in this all the way to the bitter end if it saves my son.
Goes. Where did he go? To the left. Yeah, to the left. Let me go. Just dead end. I made a patch of glass.
Together, Ethan, come on.
I can't get out of this loop. I'm trying. Why don't we go for it?
I couldn't. I wasn't able to.
Wow. Well. Oh my.
Oh my God. Ethan, can you hear me? Calm down, girl. There must be something I can do to help him. Oh my God. What happened to him?
You've got a hell of a fever. I'm gonna have to get your clothes. Arms look really bad. I need to disinfect your wounds.
Okay, let me get some something for his cuts.
I'm gonna have to get your clothes off to disinfect those wounds.
Uh. You go to the bathroom. See if I see anything I can use.
I'm no doctor, but I'll do what I can. Sorry. I'll go easier. Sorry. I'll go easier. Sorry. I'll go easier.
Trying to go fast.
Sorry. I'll go easier.
Just kidding.
Sorry, I'll go easier.
Geez, I'm not sure I'm helping him. I better stop.
That's so funny.
How do you feel?
Water.
I've been better. Was I out for long?
About 7 years.
Why the Guardian Angel Act? You don't even know me.
When I was a child, I was always the one who used to fix my brothers up when they'd been fighting with the other kids on the block. I suppose I like to play the guardian angel.
You said you were here because you're an insomniac?
I've been going through a bit of a tough patch the last few months. The kind of stuff you prefer to forget. I do what I can to live with it, but it's not easy.
It's not easy being cheated.
That's the second time I found you in a bad way. You always seem to be running for your life. What's happening, Ethan?
Mm. Sorry.
Listen, I'm truly grateful for your help, but for your own sake, I think it's better if you don't ask any questions.
Maybe I could help you.
No one can help me. You've already done a lot, Madison.
Right. I'm gonna go. Take care.
So funny.
I didn't do it. I swear I didn't do it. I've got nothing to do with that business. I never killed nobody.
Oh, no. Then why did you run away when they came to question you?
I already told you I forgot to report to my parole officer. I didn't want to go back to prison. When I saw the cops, I just bolted. I wasn't thinking straight.
We checked out his statement. He has an alibi for at least three of the murders.
Fuck, that bastard was a perfect fit. Shit!
There you go.
Ash? Okay. Sean Moss's mother's here. She'd like to speak with you.
It was a few months back. The middle of the night. It was pouring down. Ethan came home completely drenched at about 3. I asked him where he'd been. He spoke about drowning, the rain. He didn't make any sense. There was something. Something in his eyes. As if it wasn't really him. There may be no connection. But the next day, there was that announcement about another victim of the Origami Killer. Find my son. I'm begging you.
Police Lieutenant Carter Blake, and this is Agent Norman Jaden of the FBI. According to our information, Ethan Mars is one of your patients. We'd like to ask you a few questions about him.
I'm sorry, that's impossible.
Doctor-patient privilege.
I'm bound by an oath of secrecy.
Yeah.
Under no circumstances may I discuss my patients.
Punch him in the face.
My job is to find Sean Mars alive, and I don't give a damn about any bullshit oath.
I know you don't want to protect a murderer. If you know anything, you must tell us, Doctor.
I'm sorry. I can't help you. And now I must ask you to leave.
You need to cooperate. For your own sake.
He's right. Legally, you gotta tell us what you know.
Are you threatening me?
I'm just giving you some free advice, Doc. I suggest you take it.
Doctor, a child's life is at stake. You may know something that could help us save him.
I am going to call the police and make a complaint about your behavior.
Doctor, you are really pushing my buttons. The only thing I'm interested in is saving that kid's life.
So, you're going to be a good boy and tell me what I want to know, or I am really going to lose my temper.
John Mars' life may depend on what you know. Tell us what you know, Doctor.
Let go of me. You have no right.
Punch him.
Come on, Doc.
He needs information.
Easy way and a hard way.
your fucking choice.
You want to do it the hard way.
If you don't let go of this man immediately, I'll report you and you'll be off the case.
What the hell's the matter with you, Norman? Were you getting cold feet? You don't want to save Sean Mars anymore?
I want to save Sean Mars just as much as you do, but that doesn't give me all rights. So you're going to stop this shit right now.
Ethan Mars has had psychological problems since his first son died. Feels responsible for his death. A sort of morbid neurosis. He is haunted by visions of drowning bodies. A few weeks ago, after one of our usual sessions, I found this on the floor.
Hold on.
It must have fallen out of his pocket.
I could see that.
Ash, I want you to assign every available man to finding Ethan Mars. I want a man outside his place day and night. Notify all agencies to start looking for him. I want you to keep an eye on the train stations, the airports, the bus terminals. I want every cop in the city on his ass, so that if he moves, we know about it. Yes, Ethan Mars is the origami killer.
Alright. I'm what, 5 hours into the story? Yeah, this is my 5th hour. That guy. Is that the father of that guy? Oh, okay. There's a bug.
Nice shot.
Thank you. Please come in, Mr. Shelby. Would you care for a coffee?
Oh, no thanks.
Do you play?
I tried once, but I think the owner of the course is still looking for me.
It's an interesting sport. It requires strength, but also a cool head and absolute precision. Would you care to hit a few balls with me? There's no danger of damaging the greens here.
Okay.
Take off your jacket and grab a club.
I kick his butt.
The balls are in that basket.
Here you go. Quick time.
The most important thing is to grip the club correctly. When you feel ready, you swing.
R1. Here we go. Up. Yeah. That's kind of weak.
Hell, it's only your first ball. You should try to strike it a little harder next time.
I think I gotta go down at the controller hard.
I'm assuming you didn't invite me here just to play golf, Mr. Kramer.
I hear you've been asking questions about my son.
That's right. I want to know if Gordy is linked to the origami killer case in any way.
Here you go. Now one. Now one. Ooh, there we go.
My son had nothing to do with that sordid case.
Well, then he has nothing to fear from my investigation.
You have no business investigating my son. I told you, he had nothing to do with it.
With all due respect, Mr. Kramer, it's up to me to decide who I want to investigate.
I'm an influential man, Mr. Shelby, and I pay very well for loyalty.
Are you trying to buy me?
Let's just say I'm trying to show you where your interest lies. How much do you want to leave my son alone?
I think you misunderstood me. I don't play that game.
Don't go near my son, Mr. Shelby. If you do, you'll regret it.
But I have ethics, no, ethics.
Have a nice day, Mr. Kramer.
All the money in the world is more than $1 trillion. I don't know. I would assume so, but has to be, right? I don't really know, though. You have to Google it. You'll have to Google it. I think they said no, I gotta go sleep. We had like four or five people come by and watch.